Right, let's play Hellberg real quick.
This motherfucker don't miss.
No, he's fucking good.
That motherfucker don't miss, man.
He's good.
In the heat of battle, he don't miss.
No.
In the heat of controversy, he don't miss.
Let's just bring this up a little bit.
Okay, Hellberg, real different for him, Saba. You wouldn't know that, but very, very different, different vibe for bro.
So last night, we were once again part of the Kenny Beats beat battle. Now, it didn't go, unfortunately, as well as it did last time, but we did get some great feedback from Kenny and the guest judge, Saba. And I thought that we would look at the track and see what I could have done differently and what kind of my reasoning was behind it. But before we get into it, here's the sample that Kenny provided us with. So that was the sample, and here's what I did with it.
This motherfucker don't miss.
No, he's fucking good.
That motherfucker don't miss, man.
He's good.
In the heat of battle, he don't miss.
No.
In the heat of controversy, he don't miss.
Let's just bring this up a little bit. Damn, shawty.
Whenever the hi-hat loop was in, I didn't notice it as much, but the drums towards the end, when it's just the bass with the kick and the snare without the percussion in the middle, it felt a little stale, like swing-wise, and I think your drum sounds could have been crazier, Hellberg, but other than that, everything you played was fire, like a really interesting flip on it. I really liked your bass tone, and even the guitar tone, but they're too loud. The instruments are way louder than your drums are, and the drums, because they're so, like, wide and big instead of sharp, like, I don't know, they're really fighting to compete with it. And I think with something like that, it feels like a big rhythm section, you want the drums to shine.
I thought that was one of the more interesting flips. Mm-hmm. Like, it was definitely, like, entertaining. It was like you didn't really know what was gonna happen. I wasn't a fan of a lot of like the sound choices of, there was something that happened around like 38-39 mark where one of the kicks came in super offbeat, and I really fuck with shit like that.
Yeah.
So that was tight.
You're definitely up there, Hellberg. I just like seeing him doing something so different for him, because you expect him to do one thing and he didn't. Shout out to you, Hellberg.
All right, so that was the flip. It may not sound like it, but this was like super challenging for me. I don't usually do this kind of unquantized hip-hop stuff. When I do hip-hop, it's usually in the more trap lane. So the piano that is playing here is the melody from the sample. Here's the damn shawty clip.
Let's just bring this up a little bit. Damn shawty.
So his regular voice is here.
Let's just bring this up a little bit.
And then I pitch this up to semitones.
Damn, shawty.
So that it would be in the key of the song, which I thought was funny. Chords in the bass line here. Both the bass sounds are Scarby Rickenbacker. I've talked about this plugin previously. Love this plugin, it's great. And also Keyscape, which I've also talked about previously. Pretty Rhodes thing. Very, got a little bit of a tremolo on it. Very classic. And we also got this Rhodes that is playing the solo here. That's got some distortion on it in Keyscape, as well as some decapitator and a reverb from Valhalla, which is basically the only reverb I use. And this was just me playing around on the piano, really, finding something that could work with the chords and everything else. So together with the live bass, we also have an 808. K Can't remember really where this 808 is from. I do think that it's on Splice though. I'm pretty sure that I've downloaded this from Splice. The 808 is actually in mono, but I made it stereo with the doubler and then with Pro Q taking out the low end of the side so that it doesn't mess up too much with the low end. So a big part of this song is obviously the drums, and that was kind of the biggest challenge for me. A big part of the drums is this loop made by The Count. He's like a sample maker and a producer. He makes these great acoustic loops. So I never go into this much on quantized territory. Like, there's a lot of stuff here that's not on beat at all. And that was definitely a challenge for me, which I love about these like beat battles, is how much they can challenge you and make you like try out new shit that you wouldn't do otherwise. So with those livey drums, we have a couple of kicks that we pair them up with. We also have all of the instruments sidechained to those kicks, which I thought made for a cool sound. And also with the acoustic loop, we have this rim. And that is kind of just doubling the snare. Also got a shaker and some percussion. Looking back on it, I'm not super sure about this loop that I included, but it was kind of a heat in the moment thing that I just went for. We also got a ride from a Count sample pack, which I love. Really pulls the whole drum section together in my opinion. Got a few tom fills, also from The Count. This like whole beat is The Count. Also got like a crowd noise with kids playing in the background and a vinyl noise. Another thing that we brought from the sample is this noise over here, which kind of acted as our effects for the whole beat. The beat becomes very empty without that, so that was kind of key. In the second part here, we have a guitar coming in. I was not super happy about the guitar. That's kind of why it's not in the forefront, because I felt like I have to have it in because it's playing the melody of the sample. And without that, I'm kind of cheating because I'm not like using the sample enough, basically. Not really happy about how the guitar is sounding, but you know, it's the best I could do with the amount of time that we had. Also, this is disabled and it takes up a lot of CPU, so I'm just gonna delete that. One of the things that Kenny said was the drum sound and having them kind of be more punchy and bring them out in the mix a little. I think that me working on headphones is kind of an issue there. I could definitely have worked way more on the drums. I think I relied a lot on the Count loop, and with the time constraints, it's just difficult to like fine tune stuff like that. Now, one of Saba's criticisms was that he just wasn't a fan of the sounds that much. Definitely could have been way more picky with the sounds. It was kind of like me just choosing something and just going with it. The guitar, even though it's sounding not great, that took a lot of time, while maybe the keys and the bass was just like, oh, let's go, just do it. So one thing that I thought was a great idea late last night when turning this project in was this last part. I feel like I could have done this way better, introduced a new instrument or something that just wasn't a breakdown of the drums and the bass. This is where kind of Kenny got thrown off as well, it seemed like, and I don't know, I'm just like not happy about this part. I feel like this hurt the overall rating, I guess, or whatever you want to call it, of the song. So yeah, that's kind of the beat, guys. Like, there's not a lot of elements going on, but getting all those few elements right is what was the big challenge for me here, and uncharted territory. If you're still watching this, then please like the video, it would mean a lot to me, and comment down below what you want to see more of. And if you're into this type of content, then subscribe, because there's a lot more coming. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on Twitter, I guess. Bye.
This motherfucker don't miss.
No, he's fucking good.
That motherfucker don't miss, man.
He's good.
In the heat of battle, he don't miss.
No.
In the heat of controversy, he don't miss.
Let's turn his brightness up a little bit. Damn, shawty.